A newly opened one-stop vaccination site in the Bangsamoro region sees a good turnout. Over 100 children were vaccinated during the site's opening Thursday. The site offers vaccines not just for COVID, but for other diseases as well. More inoculation sites such as this are expected to be set up in the region. Only a little over 40% of the Bangsamoro population are fully vaccinated against COVID-19. Less than 10% have had their booster shots. Local health officials aim to further convince those who refuse to be vaccinated to finally get their shot.
Kailangan lang po silang bigyan ng mga tamang impormasyon. Pero dun po sa hardcore, I think na yun po yung mga problema natin talagang ayaw sa ayaw. Pero tayo pa rin po dito sa BARM ay puspusan pa rin po yung ating pangangampanya.
U.S. President Joe Biden contracts COVID-19. Biden's doctors say the 79-year-old is experiencing mild fatigue and would isolate at the White House while carrying out his full duties. The White House says Biden is taking Pfizer's antiviral drug Paxlovid to minimize the severity of the disease. On Twitter, Biden posted a picture of himself working at his desk and apologized for missing a scheduled event in Pennsylvania.
Hey folks, guess you heard. This morning I tested positive for COVID. But I've been double vaccinated, double boosted. Symptoms are mild. And I really appreciate your inquiries and your concerns. But I'm doing well, getting a lot of work done, going to continue to get it done. And in the meantime, thanks for your concern. And keep the faith. It's going to be okay.
Here at home, Transportation Secretary Jaime Bautista is the latest Marcos cabinet member to test positive for COVID-19. Bautista is now in isolation. He is exhibiting mild symptoms, including headache and cough. He is expected to miss President Ferdinand Marcos Jr.'s first State of the Nation address Monday. A Philippine lawmaker wants President Marcos to declare rising inflation as a so-called public enemy number one during Monday's SONA. Albay Representative Joey Salceda says Marcos should present specific programs geared towards helping sectors most affected by soaring fuel and commodity prices. He says the president may even ask Congress to grant him special powers.
Calling out to, for example, the AFP and, you know, all the others, the uniform personnel, in order to finish certain infrastructure na sa ngayon po nakabinbin at para po hindi po magkaroon ng logistical bottleneck, isa na po yan. Pangalawa, yung pagbibigay po ng loans o ng mga ayuda sa mga MSME na para po kasi sa ngayon, ba, may budget pero wala po ngayon sa GAA, sa GAA. She should have that power to use savings and augment without having to go through Congress and augment those funds.
Salceda also wants Marcos to increase government's infrastructure spending. He's also in favor of renegotiating loan agreements struck with China for railway projects worth nearly $5 billion. The deal was earlier scrapped due to China's failure to act on the funding requests.
The North-South Commuter Railway, the PNR South Long Haul, as well as, of course, the Mindanao Railways are very critical infrastructure projects. We can easily find others. But I think as of now, the better option really is now that the Chinese says, okay, we will talk about it again. I think basically let's talk about it because, for example, for Bicol, I've seen 17 status reports already on that project. So I don't know why we should just suddenly withdraw from it.
Senator Sonny Angara also expects President Marcos to give solutions to rising prices, particularly in terms of agricultural inputs. Angara believes while the new administration's plan to import cheap fertilizers will help farmers lower production costs, there may be a better way to go about it in the long run.
fertilizer is one of the most important inputs. No? So, although merong short-term measures like this, dapat yung nabanggit natin yung tatak din. Also, look to maybe establishing your own industry. Because if you're using this product every day, if it's crucial to your national development and to your progress, then why not have a strong domestic industry in the long run? Meron ng mga developments dyan on a small level, especially yung ating mga state universities and colleges.